let it bang, bang.
Now in Harissa Kheti Aquaculture System Project, which is funded by NFDP Hyderabad, and it is situated in College of Fisheries Delhi, and myself Satyam of College of Fisheries Delhi. And today we are going to discuss the different components of recirculatory aquaculture system by Masters of Fishery Science second year student Sardim Hazarika. Sir, so you can start.
Thank you, Satyam. So I'll be covering in brief about what is recirculatory ecosystem. First of all, this recirculatory ecosystem system project is being funded by National Fisheries Development Board, which has been assigned to College of Fisheries Dholi. This project is guided by Dr. Shivendra Kumar, who is currently the main person behind the whole project, as well as our respected Honorable Dean Sir, Dr. S. C. Rai. So let's go into details. First of all, let us know what is RAS. RAS is a technology wherein the water is reused, it is recycled, and then it is again pumped back into the system. The reason behind it is that the water that is being utilized, it is returned into a usable form, because the water which is dirty, which is full of metabolites, it's considered as a maintenance for the cultured fish species. So in order to prevent that, we have certain components in the RAS which serves the purpose for it. Then, first of all, let us know what's the advantage of RAS. First of all, as I have said before, the land area required is less, the water area required is less, the water consumption is less. And moreover, here we have a biofilter which serves the purpose of nitrifying the bacteria, which contains nitrifying bacteria, which serves the purpose of reducing the more harmful toxic metabolites into a less harmful or toxic form.
Sir, could you explain the components of the recirculatory aquaculture system, that how it works and the mechanism behind this?
Sure. First of all, the components in our RAS is composed of the culture tank, where it consists of three cages. There the fish species that is to be cultured is grown out there. Then secondly, we have four aeration systems, which are also known as air injector systems, which provides 24/7 oxygenation to the cultured water, so that for the fish to thrive well. Thirdly, we have our biofilter, which converts the nitrifying bacteria, which converts the harmful toxic metabolites into a least harmful form. Because there in a biofilter, we have bioballs, which are fitted inside, which serves as a substratum for the nitrifying bacteria that grows inside there.
You mean it is the main role of the biofilter, rights are the main role of the animals?
Yes. Then this, what the bioballs, what they do is that this provide a substrate for the, as I've said before, they provide a substrate for the nitrifying bacteria, which convert the ammonia that is released into the system, that is taken up from the system, that is a culture tank, into the biofilter. It converts it into nitrite, which is a intermediate form and is considered toxic, and is then reduced to, it is converted into nitrate, which is the least active form or at least toxic form.
Sir, could you identify the components of RAS?
Yes, sure. As you can see, they are the air injector systems or the aeration systems, followed by the fish culture tank. These are three culture cages that are being used, followed by, it is a biofilter. It contains the bioballs, which serves the purpose as I have said before. Here we have three blowers. These blowers serves the purpose of providing emergency aeration whenever required, because in some cases there might be instances where electricity might not be available. At such cases, it provides the emergency oxygen required for the fishes to thrive and survive. Then it's followed by two centrifugal pumps. Then it's followed by two centrifugal pumps. These centrifugal pumps, one centrifugal pump works as a suction pump, where inside the culture tank an outlet is present, which sucks the through which the water is being sucked inside and is directed into the overhead tank, through which by gravity the water from the overhead sump tank goes into the biofilter for the conversion process. Then we have another centrifugal pump which serves as a purpose for removing the slurry and helps in removing the water when and whenever required. Moreover, we have an inverter unit which could be used to provide emergency aeration or electricity whenever and wherever means required. Yeah, sure. The fee that we are providing is given based on the body weight. Generally, in RAS, 3-5% body weight fee is generally given. Moreover, the fee that are we've been using, it is procured from many different feed companies, which may be from Godrej, which may be from Growell, which may be from Abyss, whichever applicable for the culture species which provides good growth. Then the culture species that could be grown here or could be farmed here would be tilapia, pearl spot, fungus ears, sea bass, cobia and so on. However, in a country like India, many studies have been still going on so as to make it possible for the small scale farmers to undergo this RAS practice. Since many species like tilapia, fungus ears has shown good progress in terms of providing growth in RAS. However, very less literature is available which could provide greater details on the production aspects of fish species in RAS.
Sir, one more thing. How could be RAS benefited to fish farmers and fisheries community?
Yes, first of all, RAS primarily have been developed, this technology has been developed primarily for the small scale farmers, and those farmers and for those people and fisher folk community which has low land area where water is scarce, where the water is continuously depleted in areas where these factors are present, there RAS serves a purpose where in a small land area we could gain more production by stocking species at a higher rate, and that too stocking high value species who should give profit to the farmers and the fisher folk community. But the thing is that there are few constraints in that. The first constraint is that we need 24/7 electricity. Power consumption is required for running the whole entire operation. Secondly, we must have a proper aeration system, because if we do not have a proper aeration system, the oxygen that is required by the fish species would not be available for them, and it would result in fish loss or the loss in the fish stock. Thirdly, we need skilled manpower, and in a country like India we still have a problem of skilled manpower. So it's necessary for fish folk community or a fish farmers who want to adopt this particular culture practice, they need to undergo intensive training that has been provided by our premium institutes which have adopted this RAS technology for production in experimental scale or in a production scale. So that's it.
Thank you so much, sir. This is the informative content of the recirculatory aquaculture system that is uploaded on BeFishCo YouTube channel. So thank you so much for being with us, Mr. Dev sir. Thank you, sir.